Hi everyone, this is Yip from Evolution Fitness, physical therapist and master trainer for myofascial trigger point release. Today I want to share some of the exercises that you can do for those suffering from shoulder issues related injury, for instance, frozen shoulders, or due to injury, shoulder pain, restriction of movement, okay, that you have difficulty lifting your hands, either left or right, or bending to the back, that you limit your day-to-day activity, for instance, removing of your shirt. For ladies, I'm working on your bra. So on the things, on a monthly basis, we actually see a lot of patients for shoulder-related problems. And often is other than doing myofascial release treatment, we always prescribe them with a whole list of exercises for them to do to improve and work on the shoulders. So today I'm going to show you. But before that, let's take a look at anatomy of the shoulder. Now the shoulder joint is a very complex joint altogether. It's one of the most versatile joints in the body, which is actually a ball and socket joint. It allows us to turn 360 degrees. Now if you look from the skeleton, the shoulder joint actually is just slightly attached to the shoulder girdle, just hinging above, and it's actually supported by the surrounding muscles. So any trauma or any overuse will create inflammation or trigger point in the shoulders that leads to a lot of discomfort, pain, often referred pain or tension in the shoulders. Now when we deal with treatments for shoulder pain, other than dealing with the direct muscles associated with the issues, we also have to work with the muscles surrounding, either the exterior, the front, back, top, and also underneath. Also that we will want to promote a healthy fascia in all dimensions to allow the body or the shoulder to move freely. Now without further ado, I'm going to show you how to use the wall as our assist. A series of exercises that you can do on your own, alright, for your shoulders. So are you ready? Let's move over to the wall and I will guide you through. Please follow me. Alright, so now I'm going to show you how to use the wall to assist in our stretch for the shoulders. First exercise, stand away from the wall facing in with your palms against the wall. Lean forward, we want to hinge from your hip. So to observe that the hip should be directly over your ankle. Press down, push into the wall to create space. Now what we want is to keep the back straight, to avoid rounding. So engage those muscles on the upper back, squeezing, lengthening, and push backward. And once you got into this action, bring your shoulders away from your ears. You should feel the stretch coming from the upper back between the scapula. For those who can, you can go slightly higher for a deeper stretch in the front chest and opening of the shoulders. You can hold there for about 30 seconds to 1 minute. So common mistake is people tend to lean into it. Okay, so this one create too much pressure. So what you want is to lengthen and create space. Okay, second exercise, same direction, we'll be working on the left side. So place your left hand sliding up towards the wall, hip away from the wall, both feet together. In this position, keep walking your hands up, right, and going down. So what you feel, okay, the stretch of the shoulders, it should be pain-free. Right, the pain that you experience should be that of the stretch and not those of sharp pain as in your nerve impingement. So you have to listen to your own body. Go as much as your body allows. Each time when you can, open it higher and drop your hip towards the wall using your body weight as an assist. Same movement, hold for 30 seconds to 1 minute. Second exercise, bend your elbow, place your palms on your neck and lengthen to create space. So keep the elbow in line with your shoulder instead of moving forward. In line, leaning in. If you can, walk the elbow slightly higher. What we want to stretch is actually the teres major and your minor just below your shoulder blade. So minimal pressure on your neck. Hand is only using there as a support. Continue breathing, smooth, continual breath. Each time you exhale, that's when you try to deepen the stretch if possible. Same thing, listen to your body. Do not go beyond what your body can feel. Okay. Third exercise, bend your elbow, shoulder level, palms against the wall. Whichever hip that is outside, that leg will be in front in a straight line. Option, bend your knees slightly. We are working on the left inner thigh, outer. So right hand on your hip, inhale, exhale, push your hip into the wall, stretch, and up for 10 times. Exhale, pushing in, inhale, coming out. Exhale, in. On the last count, 10, going down, hold for 20 to 30 seconds. So feel the stretch going down from your left hip down towards your ankle. And out. Okay, so now next we're going to turn to the other side. With the left leg in front this time, right leg behind, one straight line. Right hand straighten all the way. We are working on the left upper side trunk. Left hand from the side, push your left hip outward, bring your left hand towards the wall. Inhale, exhale, fold. Try to have your shoulders in the same plane as your elbow. Exhale, side. Keep pushing your hip up to create a nice C curve. Continue breathing for 10 count. On the last rep, push and hold the position, continue breathing, 30 seconds, and slowly coming out. Now, next exercise that you want to work on the shoulders other than the side, front, you want to work on the outer shoulder. Press the palm, turn the palm facing back against the wall, rotate your body facing in. You can either fold your elbow, rest your forehead in, or you can put it at the side. Turn and use your body weight to lean into the wall. Same thing, hold between 30 seconds to 1 minute. So in this position, you just have to allow your body weight to do the job. Next, left palm. Okay, I will show you from this direction. Imagine this is my left hand. Palms into the wall. The front shoulder should be imprinted into the wall itself. Now from here, we're going to turn to the side, rotate so that the shoulder, the inner shoulder, is actually pressing into the wall to create space. So from the left hand, it looks like this, turning in, turn as much as my body allows. I can use the right hand to push into the wall to deepen. Right. So these are the few stretches that we can work for those who have shoulder issues, shoulder pain, frozen shoulders, or having problem lifting up. So you can do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Alright, thanks for watching our videos, and I hope you'll find it beneficial. For more videos related to exercise and rehab tips, okay, that we'll be sharing further on, do like our Facebook page and our YouTube, and subscribe to our YouTube channel, Evolution Fitness. Alright, listed below here. I'll see you again in a short while, and all the best. Have a good day. You make the fight. You can see the light.